Okay, hey everybody, this is Grace, and I'm over here again today to make videos. I'm taking a few days off from, I don't know how long, till my feet and ankles and legs aren't swollen. It's mainly right now, it's just my ankles. But anyway, I want to get to this. Part of that's going to be in with what I want to talk about today, and that is when these narcissistic people, you know, whether they're diagnosed or just, I don't diagnose, if they have been, I wouldn't know. But their behaviors are rather narcissistic in this one way, at least this one way, and that is when they exploit people. Okay, and in order to do this, I'm going to give a life update of my own experiences. And my degrees are in psychology and sociology. I taught at college and university, and as I've said, I have had plenty of experience firsthand also with people who are narcissistic, and especially with those with this histrionic blend of behaviors. Like I said, I don't know, I've been diagnosed with anything but some borderline personality disorder. So, okay, now you get to see somebody cutting down trees in front of me. But anyway, this of people being very exploitative, to, you know, from others to achieve their own goals. And you know, somebody narcissistic to achieve their own goals. And in this, whenever I see histrionic behavior blended with it, is say that they are, you know, they're really adult. Now they're adults. Adult mean girls and adult mean boys. And the one that is doing this, the one that's really the narcissistic one, they may all have a group narcissism, but the main one is the queen bee, the top dog, this kind of thing, and this kind of, you know, kind of person. And they, you know, those are expressions, queen bee, top dog. For someone who's at the top and all the people underneath them, you know, all the people associated with them who see them in that sense as the top dog, a queen bee, they protect them. You know, they're flying, well, some call them flying monkeys, you know, like on the Wizard of Oz. I remember as a child watching that, and the witch and her flying monkeys, and being so terrified of those flying monkeys when I was a child. Seriously. And so, and her too, it was creepy. And it makes total sense to me. And I remember thinking back then, this is going to mean something to me one day. You know, something along this line, this is important, I better watch it. Yeah, because that's what I've pretty much been around my whole life. Okay, that type. That they have their queen bee, and far too often it's somebody that I know. And they just attack. You know, they just, boom, they come in. Attack. You can't defend yourself against anybody that you can't say anything about them because they have all of those, you know, there to protect them. All those people there, you know, to protect them. And you against them. Now the reason it's on my mind is because tomorrow I go to see that, oh, I was supposed to look it up, but that practice, I'm going back to that practice that I had been to for years, going on for 11 years. Well, no, not 11 years. Since 2011 or 2012. So maybe it was 11 years. Oh, my goodness. But going back to see them, that insurance thing, this, like I said, a life update involving all this. I saw two providers, and altogether it would have been four. The first one canceled the appointment, and I was supposed to see the nurse, so the nurse would do like the yearly, and then H&P, you know, and then from there they said I could fast track to the doctor. Who I wanted to see was the doctor, and it was this particular doctor. I had checked out their whole bio, everything, asked them about, you know, the corporation. Like, whoever it is, they schedule through, and it's not the same as usual at all, really. And to make sure he was what I wanted to see, You know, he wasn't going to be one to do the cherry picking, the medical cherry picking, medical lemon dropping, you know, because I have a rare health condition. They don't want to see it. It lowers their numbers. It's not like it's going to change. It's not like they can do it. It's inoperable. So, you know, they can operate on it. All this kind of stuff is, so they do that. And I wanted to ensure, well, that nurse that I was supposed to see canceled. Long story with that. Apparently I was supposed to know to check their portal, which I didn't even know they had one. Okay, you're going around circles, aren't you? He just went around in a circle. So there was that. And then I had to schedule for another one, which is in the same office. And I had actually delivered to that office, doing those delivery gig work to have the health insurance. It wasn't for the money. It was for proving that I could earn something here in Texas, to get that, affordable health care. And so I had to prove I could make a certain amount of money. Unfortunately, I had just a short while to prove of what I would make for the whole year. It turned out it couldn't happen. It just could not happen because of the heat dome, the heat wave, plus my edema, my legs swelling, the whole thing. The feet, the legs, the ankles, all that, it just wasn't going to happen because my feet would be hanging down as I'm driving. Walking was great. Driving was not. Or just sitting around. I couldn't even sit at my desk at home because it would swell. Anyway, so see, this is a life update part of it in order to get to it. Now, I did, I had rescheduled, and I thought, I didn't know that it wasn't. Because I told him, I said, this nurse canceled. I need to reschedule. They said, well, she's not there, but this one, she's off on leave or something, and here's one. So I scheduled, saw one. She had that thing of, I was feeling really good, I should know better by now. When I'm feeling really good about somebody, well, I do know this, because I was seeing some red flags. Wasn't really calling them that. Okay, I had to cut it off there for a second. I thought it was some children. It was an adult, but I didn't, and you couldn't see them anyway. I thought they would be in school today. Maybe they're homeschooled. Anyway, where was I? I had to go through and look at it. Where was I? Okay, so I went to see this. It was a nurse, and I could fast track to that doctor. And so I saw her. She had that kind of, some things weren't right. Like I told her, I just had a whole bunch of tests. It was like maybe a month and a half before at the hospital. And she said, she looked away and she looked at the computer. She said, well, I probably could see those, but, and then I don't remember the rest of it. I think she kind of laughed. Cause I remember the expression on her face. And I said, something, red flag. Something was not right about that. And another one. Okay, that woman, she's obviously the grandma. But those children, three of them, must have been born real close together. Oh my, like, have one, then they have another one. Anyway, hey, I'm like that. I'm close to one of my sisters, our ages. One of my sisters. But anyway, so where was I? I got distracted again. But there were several things like that. And plus she was saying, oh, but we do all the, she like try to find some way. I can't remember the order in which she said these things, like, oh, they do them in-house and right there. I said, oh, that's nice. And it is nice when you go to a doctor's office and they do them right there. Little did I know that the visit and those tests, they did not tell me at all. The visit and those tests came up to almost $900. I did not know this until they put the bill of what they sent to the insurance company on the portal, and I had checked it, the portal. That's how I found out. And then they were saying something like, I might be responsible for like $300 of it or something. They never said any of this stuff to me. Okay, that's very, and I am tired. I am extremely tired. of dealing with people who try to exploit others. And that's what they were doing. And I had a fear that this would happen. This kind of thing. You know, I got a fresh, shiny new health insurance card with dollar signs dangling off of it. Not been used yet. And that's the first thing that happened. Yep. You know, there was no reason for these tests. And like I had told her. And they had this portal thing where they see everything from all the kind of, that hospital isn't even associated with them, yet they can see all that, all the medications I've had for going back, I don't know how many years, and you know, all this stuff, prescriptions, all of it. And like she says, she could probably pull it up, but, you know, see what I'm saying? And that wasn't all to it. Then the office, and it probably was some miscommunication or lack of, because they don't have, their whole office staff is not in the office. Some of it, as one of them explained to me much later, they have a call center, because they get 11 of these doctor's practices. I think they said they have 11 doctors, is what she said. And out of those 11 doctors, they get 600 calls per day, you know, average. 600 calls per day. So they had to set up a call center. And so they're not even in the building with any of these. So, but altogether, it seemed like, who is calling me? Somebody in, that's what number? That's Houston, I think. I don't know anybody in Houston. Not anymore. Anyway, let me see. How do I hang this up? I don't know if you could hear it ringing or not, but anyway, so that happened, and what they did was that mean girl stuff. I'm serious. If she got what she wanted off that card, you know, she got what she wanted, okay, which was charging it up. I don't know how that works. I don't know if she gets money off of how much she earns, and all the tests, does she get any? Or does she just get brownie points? You know, what is the deal? How it all works? And trust me, it was long, long story there. And actually having to speak to the corporate office, and they said that nobody would ever call me again. Because the mean girl stuff was that they kept calling me that day. Calling me. Like I said, it could have been miscommunication between them because they're not in the same office. And so the first one who kept repeating what I said, which I'm kind of was concerned that maybe she had, you know, I've heard this, that happened before with people with that. I'm not going to say what it is, but they might repeat what you say over and over again until they feel confident in what they said, what they heard. And I told her I was on the road and I needed to, get off the phone. It was real busy. It was near a mall. It was extremely busy all the time. And, she just kept repeating what I said, and I kept saying, I know your office is capable of getting this under control and working this through, but she kept saying, well, now what you need is this, what you're saying you need is, she kept doing that. So I told her, I said, please don't call me back, you know, on my phone. I had told the nurse that I don't want any phone calls. If they can text me or send something on the, she said, what about the portal? I said, send something on the portal. You know, but don't you call me on the phone. It does. It messes it up. You know, because I use my phone for work. So you see, I don't need them calling me. So what did I do? I kept getting phone calls from them over and over and over that day. So I spoke to the corporate office. How can I make this stop? I told them not to call me. I told the nurse. I told all of them. Long conversation with this woman who actually kind of intimated that they were working. Okay, too many kids later. I've edited them out. Hopefully it sticks. Sometimes it doesn't. You know, I don't put other people's kids. And they were kind of far away, but still. Anyway, let me get to the story, man. Too many distractions. But, so where was I? That whole scene there was, you know, that mean girl stuff that happens when they want to do the medical cherry picking, medical lemon dropping. I can't say for certain that's what she was trying to do. You know, before I got to see the doctor, they're gatekeepers kind of thing. I've seen so much of this in my life having had this since I was a child. It's pathetic. And by the way, the other day I did see, go to the day that I said, called the marketplace and said, I don't want this insurance. You know, it was not worth it. I canceled it. I don't want it. So I went that day to that, to one of these places that treated me right. It's just that they don't, it's not a practice the same way. But anyway, I saw this new to me doctor, and well, I saw a nurse practitioner is new to me, and then came in the new doctor. Okay, that's how I had always known it to be. You see a nurse, they kind of go over stuff, and then you see a doctor. That's how it's always been practiced. So here in Texas, though, nurse practitioners, they can practice without the doctor, as far as I know. I'm not a lawyer or any of that, so I don't know how that works. And, you know, that's not my area, so I'm not going to speak as though I'm a voice authority, because I'm not. But that's how, what I understand it to be. And I would rather see a doctor. I would rather see an experienced doctor. Or one who is not, doesn't have, and I never can remember the expression. I don't even know the expression. Like, they don't have, they're not going to make any money off of it. These are volunteers. There are several places around here that are volunteers and that are run by volunteers. And that's exactly what I need. So they won't be trying to exploit everything that they can from me. You know, they can't be trying to get rid of me because they say, well, you don't have the insurance to go get this done or that done. No, they actually send, I'm going to have a sonogram for my legs and for circulation. She said, I have perfect. Seems like perfect in circulation in my feet. So I don't know what's going on with one of my foot. One of my feet. Oh my goodness, it's been so much, too much this year. Seriously, too much this life, really. But I'm pretty tired. I'm rather worn out. You know, I was really sick really bad in May and June. And was in the ER 3 times, twice in May, once in June, and all I heard was crickets. She asked me about that. I said, I gave the records here, and I left them here, a copy of them. But basically, she asked me, she said, I'm so sorry you went through all that. She kept saying that, so did the other ones. Because they'd ask me a question, and I'd answer, because she said, well, what did they tell you was the result? I said, they didn't. I had to tell her because I said, I still don't know what's going on. I think I figured it out, by the way. Just as it was with that that medication I figured out myself after 21, I quit counting at 21 health care providers. I saw over 2.5 years, meaning there were more. And I'll put my book up here before I forget it, back in this thing. But I quit counting, and they couldn't figure out what was wrong with me. That ended in 2012 when I figured it out. Just think about that. I had to figure it out. Okay, you know, I had this rare health condition. There's at least one good thing it gave me was a genius IQ. Seriously, I did it through as I would. Okay, as someone with a genius IQ would. I figured it out. You know, what is causing it? It was always allergic to a medication, trial and error, all that. And it was in a medication. I'm allergic to any in that family of medications. And did not know that then, of course. But I had been telling them, something's not right about that medication, being that medication. I still don't know how to describe it because now both books come on. It's going to fall out, including a Bible. A little Bible, one of those. It's a little Bible. I don't remember the names of them, but anyway, you get to hear all this noise. That kind of noise, when I hear it, I like it. I'm one of those, you know, that like the ASMR kind of thing. But I don't watch those ASMR, the fake, you know, those kinds of things. But natural sounds, yeah. It naturally happens. Oh, now my alarm's going off. Okay. Okay, that was one of my alarms. Goes off 7 times a day to take medication. Yeah, 7 times a day. Medication sometimes it includes supplements, and yeah, and sometimes it's just for insulin twice a day. Anyway, I seldom have any time when I'm not distracted by something other than what I want to be doing at the time. Seldom. Seriously. Because those 7 times it goes off is spread out across the day. You know, really. So anyway, where was I? Okay, I mentioned this all about that one doctor, and I'm going to go back to see the next one. The one at the practice, and that practice is the one that the was an MA, you know, medical assistant. Yeah, these are people who could go to school, and it's usually some kind of like academy or something for like possibly 5 to 6 weeks. Sometimes it's a year. It just depends on which one they choose or which one they can get in, whatever. Now, that does not make them, you know, someone, as far as I know, like I said, I'm not a lawyer. I'm not giving none of that. From what I understand is they cannot give medical advice. But some of them will elevate themselves up to the point where they think they're the same as a nurse practitioner or a doctor. I've seen it too many times before. And no, they're not that. They cannot diagnose. They cannot, you know, give medical advice. From what I understand, now somebody correct me if I'm wrong, if that somehow suddenly has changed. As far as I know, it has not. I could be wrong, like I said. But no, I'm fairly certain I'm not wrong. You don't go to school 5-6 weeks and suddenly you're a medical, you know, you give diagnoses? No. Or medical advice? No. I cannot imagine, even in Texas, that would be allowed. And when I spoke to that office manager, this one, she agreed. She said no. And she said I was supposed to only speak to one person. That's this appointment I have tomorrow. Adam's going with me. I had changed it. It was supposed to be earlier this week. And I said, no. I asked him when he could go with me. Because I think it could be her. They never would tell me her name right. I would ask them to spell it for me. And they would spell it in different ways. They wouldn't make it clear. They wouldn't do the thing like N as in Nancy or N as in Nun or whatever. They wouldn't do that. Yeah. They all... And I'm telling you, Mean Girls stuff, they have a queen bee, and they, you know, queen bee, or for a while there in between, they had, I think, a male doctor. He's no longer there. Wonder why. I know one of their nurses was so afraid. I am not kidding. She was afraid of them. A nurse there, and she come and stayed hung out in the room with me because she said, I just don't want to be around them. I am not kidding. And I am used to women. I don't think she did this for this reason, but she could have. They hang with me because I'm a gentle giant, protector of women is what I used to say when I was younger. Don't say that now, but yeah, I knew that some people, when they get scared, they come around me to protect them. Women, okay. You know, wherever we were, yeah, for whatever reason. And she gave off those vibes, but she said things like, I don't want to be around them. So she's just hung out with me until I was ready to go and they had another one set up. You know, that she goes in the room with them. She's still there. I feel for her. She can be a little mean girl too, but overall, no. I think she is legitimately afraid of them. She should be, I think. My personal opinion. On this one, F is the one that answered the phone. The name, she said her name, I understood it this time, and I'm pretty sure. I'm go back and forth on if it's her because the first letter is different. And they may have been telling me wrong before because they were protecting her because of what she did. Yeah, I have a feeling she was, yeah. Yeah, there's a long story there too, but you don't give medical advice. And the... office manager agreed, just like the corporate office and everything. But has anything ever done about these? No, seriously. So then there was one more. With that insurance, I saw a podiatrist because I've been having these swellings and everything. And she, with her, it was no need for red flags. She wasn't that swift with it. She just kind of basically didn't. You know, some of these people who are very narcissistic and they're exploiting others, they don't see that it is an issue. they see that this is normal practices. That they see an insurance card, okay, let's run a bunch of tests. And in their minds, it makes sense to even run tests, which is, I think, considered, there's fraud and abuse. I think it's the abuse part. Just run a bunch of tests just because, you know, they can. You know, and that I could be wrong on that. You know, I used to do medical billing, but I could be wrong on that. And I wasn't a coder, and I wasn't that deep into it. But I remember that something like that. Something. I could be wrong. All around. And that was a lifetime ago. I did that while I was a career student for over 20 years at university. I did jobs like that filled in. You're missing the fun part of the guy hanging off the tree over. Is he any kids around? Oh, now he's gonna stop. He was zooming around the tree. It was kind of neat. Seriously. It was kind of neat to see him do that. But anyway. In fact, it looks like rain, huh? But, so I saw this podiatrist, and I saw her because of my feet were swollen. And she had to have x-rays. She needed x-rays. Let's see if something's going on in there. Now, some of that can make sense. Makes logical sense. She also said I would need a sonogram, which they didn't tell me how much all this stuff is going to cost either. You know, I had a portion of it was 20%. I knew that. And but they wouldn't say. They just, you know, everything goes fast. I did not really know that at the time, that I had to find out because they weren't going to tell me. Trust me on that. It was the call in the corporate office on the first one. And I said, now how are you expecting me to call and that practice, expecting me to call and see how much it's going to cost me to do my own work when I don't know what the nurse is going to order? I mean, really, does that make any sense? Ooh, crickets. Because it doesn't make any sense. You haven't even seen the nurse yet. But I have to verify how much it's all going to cost me myself. Seriously. Get real. Some people are pretty lousy at being the flying monkeys. Yeah, that's how I see it. But anyway, so I saw the podiatrist and she did the x-rays and she, when I came back, she goes, she had all these trainees for whatever they were training for. We're with her, like four of them, and she was looking at my foot again, and had her back turned to me, and she said, and she turned to me, and she goes, what would you say if I said that you had a broken foot? She was so excited, like elated, oh my, and I had already seen on the, hold on, okay, I'm losing my voice, but I'd already seen on the wall the posters that she did surgery to fix broken bones, like in the feet. Okay, and I told her, I said, no, I broke my foot back when I was in my 30s. I'm 60 years old. I said, I broke my foot when I was in my 30s, and the doctor back then told me I just have to literally walk it off. And those girls, those young women, they all went, oh, really? Oh, my. Okay, let's all think that through. I just walked it off, by the way, and I didn't have to have surgery. Are you thinking it through? Back then. It is fine. She didn't push to have surgery. Okay, that's not my field. I'm not a doctor, medical doctor. I can't say anything. You know? It is what it is. It was what it was. I guess back then things were different. Did I mention that I'm a genius too? No, my mama raised no fool either. Okay, so she changed the subject rather quickly. And so then she went into finding another way she can make some money, I guess. I don't know how it works, like I said. But it was to do some sonograms. And then this place that I went to that doesn't that takes people that, I don't think that one takes is just limited to people who don't have insurance. Some of them are, some of them aren't. And it's a walk-in, though. You can walk in. Maybe that's the difference. And but they're all volunteers, so they don't have any. There's several of those, seriously, around here, and so they're not going to get any money off of it, you know. And this one, she told me about the sonogram, and I was thinking, Wow, man, that sonogram that they want me to do, they didn't do, you know, the x-rays, the portion that I had to pay for the x-rays, is it going to be the same as the total of those sonograms? That just doesn't seem right. I don't know. Okay, I really don't know. But basically, I'm thinking, huh. You know, I mean, seriously, my out-of-pocket is going to be the total, okay? Total, because I don't have insurance anymore because I let it go. I said, screw that. I am not on this plan so somebody can exploit me. And that's how I see it. That company, they were, that those doctors, their practices, whatever. Some people walking right in front of me right now with the kids. But they were trying to exploit it. Like I said, dangling dollar signs off of that new, fresh insurance card. You and I could be wrong about all that, but still, no, I don't want to be, I didn't want to have it. Adam said, oh, keep it, just keep it, you know, I'll give you the money. And I said, it's not about the money. It really is not about the money, okay, at all. It's the principle of the matter. Principle of the matter. Overall, all around, I'm losing my voice, you hear it? Okay, I could mention this also, that I'm on a medication just started with that last one that no longer works there. Then there are several that no longer work at these places. I'm serious. Since 2020, several of the providers, whether nurse practitioner, PAs, doctors, they just, it's like revolving door with these, you know. But they no longer work. They're not the volunteer one, but, yeah, well, maybe they all are. When it comes down to, I know some of them aren't, but some of them are, these different ones that are, for people without insurance. There's so many different ones. And there's sliding scale ones, types, and all this different stuff. But list and list of them. But anyway. So it's kind of hard to have a, you know, one that you trust, one that you've been to, one that you whatever. And then they have those adult mean girl stuff. And they're the queen bees. And so they all attack. You know, that is a total lack of professionalism. But anyway, so that's kind of like a total, you know, seeing this kind of exploitation. And now, on top of it, my own, I have a sister who, another sister told me what was going on with her, and I've mentioned that briefly. She called me recently again, and I told her what was going on with me with this insurance. And she was the one who said, that's good insurance. I said, I know it's good insurance. But it turned out to be that I think it's good insurance. I just think I got into the wrong people, you know, thinking that I was going to hopefully find a good one by going outside of this area. Not too far. I mean, it's just like down the road. But it's kind of outside of this area, outside of Narcissismville, what I jokingly call Narcissismville. Well, I have to reevaluate how I see Narcissismville expand its borders, and that was actually literally on the border of two places. It was weird, but anyway, so add that to it, and I just couldn't do it anymore. I mean, good, you know, not even, that's not even the thing. I'm seriously, I have not had health insurance for like somewhere around 20 years, and then I hear this from one of my sisters saying that one of our sisters was going through the one that I'm closest to in age. You know, we're real close in age. And she said she's going through it. And she lives, she lives near the Gulf Coast, and I live north of Dallas. You know, that's pretty far. 300 and something miles for, you know, close to. And anyway. So she's going through it, and she was telling her to, so she must have experienced it too. She said, don't let them take advantage of you, because they will. And that's what I felt like. I was being taken advantage of. Now, I can't prove any of that. Of course, it's all allegedly. It's all how I'm seeing it. But hey, when I get a bill for one office visit to a nurse, not even the doctor, a nurse, and the total of the bill is close to $900, unheard of. I don't owe the $900. They were saying that maybe they're trying it again with my insurance company. Yeah, right, whatever. And they didn't even inform me of this. Seriously, you know. So, hey, listen, you know, she doesn't know. Let's explain to her. But what else, how else am I going to see it? How else? I have never in my lifetime been to see a nurse practitioner that runs tests that are that expensive ever. Doctor, nurse, PA, never. Okay, even when I had insurance, never. So, oh, kid, where is your mama? This happens far too often. There's a truck coming, boy. Okay, and I said mama for a reason. It could be grandma. But, no child should be on the road on a scooter. Seriously, by themselves? A really, really young kid. Not even old enough to be in school? Really? Mama Bear. You just witnessed Mama Bear. Or Grandma Bear. I'm telling you, these days I look like that. I'm one of those everybody's grandma look type, you know. I get those vibes like you would not believe. So, and I just remembered one more funny story. I have a list of funny, weird, odd, even scary stories of doing these. Uh-oh, here she comes. You better run faster than that. Maybe she can't. But, okay, you're starting to worry me. Where is your child? Oh my God. Okay, you might hear her yelling because her kid is way down the road. And then she leaves another one over there. Tell me she didn't do that. Oh my goodness, I'm in the middle of a drama. You should never let a child that age be alone. Maybe it's time I wrap this up. My goodness, that's scary. And he is gone, man. He had his scooter, and who knows where he is now. It looks like somebody else is with the other child, so. Ah, goodness. Anyway. Threw me off. I'm still looking. Hopefully she gets him before he gets hurt. Because there are way too many people in this neighborhood who drive like they're not in a neighborhood of kids. And this is a park. This is my neighborhood, so I know. Anyway. But you see what I've been going through with this. And I didn't really want to make videos about this. Here's my alarm again. I'm going to snooze it this time. I reset it the last time. So I'm a better rack it up. I better wrap it up. I'll talk to you on another video. But you get what I'm saying so far. These are people who don't care who they exploit. How they exploit. I mean, to them, it's not. To them, this is just the norm. You know, that's the impression I get. It's just so much of the norm. And I'm now that I've said all this, I don't want to ever repeat all this again. But I can go and move on from here, hopefully. You know, oh my goodness, I hope that woman has found a man. She's still not back with him. He was, like I said, not old enough to be in kindergarten. So, anyway, it just shot my nerves. I'll talk to you on another video. Bye.